house is made of steel. You never heard of one, that's probably because they're extremely rare, but today we got an inside look.
The outside is the same as the inside. It's all metal.
It's 1,000 square feet of American history. Mark Faulkner's all-metal home sits on the same patch of Danville land where it was built decades ago.
It was a crew of like 5 men. It was like an erector set. Everything's numbered, pieced, and they just slid it all together.
Sounds simple, and it didn't take long either. 3,000 pieces of steel put together in mere hours.
They came out at 7 in the morning and left at 5 o'clock, and there was a house here.
Lustrin homes were built after World War II, when the country was in a housing crisis. They were an inexpensive alternative. Each has the same layout, 2 bedrooms, a bathroom, kitchen, and living room.
I said it would go perfect in the house.
But the homes didn't sell. The company quickly declared bankruptcy after only about 2,500 homes were ever built. Just half of them remain standing today.
My father bought the house back in 1967 as an investment property.
And now, decades later, Faulkner lives here with his wife and kids, living in and surrounded by artifacts, from these signs to radios from the 1940s and this family heirloom.
This was one of the first televisions ever made.
Besides some minor repair work,
the porcelain is just chipped away.
And a new paint job. This Lustrin looks today much as it did back in 1950.
But I really try to preserve what's there.
I've never really seen anything like that. Sort of felt like I was in a time machine. Of course, it's not all antiques. Faulkner and his family threw something at it